Hinduism needs revivers, not reformers. I want everything to be revived as it was. So last 2 years, thanks to my team, which worked tirelessly, sincerely, collecting large amount of data from the internet, how the coins looked in Kiradi, how the coins looked in Chola kingdom, how the coins looked in Surangi kingdom, how the coins looked in the Indus civilization, how the coins looked in Ganges civilization. Large amount of data is available in the internet thanks to all those archaeologists, researchers who uploaded the information in the internet and who published books. We could get all that knowledge and organize it, and we try to revive them as close as possible. As close as possible, all currencies of Kailasa will be in gold, only gold. Because gold is not just precious, in Hindu tradition, it is sacred. Gold is sacred. So, on Ganesh Chaturthi, with the grace of Ganapati, Paramashiva, Lakshmi, Venkateshwara Swami, Gubera, Swarnagarshana Bhairava, with all their grace, we will be revealing and releasing. It will be more like a ritualistic inauguration, making it into functional, may happen very soon. And I have lots of books which we studied, the list of books, we are acknowledging all of them. We are making the long list of actually books and other research articles, references, all put together, it comes to something like a 300, more than 360, 100 books, more than 100 books and other articles we collected and read from the internet and various other books and sources. Around, we are acknowledging everyone. We are thanking everyone. We made a document thanking all of them. And the exact, as close as possible to those coin models, to those format, we try to revive. So I thank everyone supported me intellectually, sharing your time. Many people who shared treasure, many people shared talent. I thank every one of you. And also Hinduism considers grain as one of the wealth. So the grains will be used for batter system. The Kailasa will have the batter system also. And one more important thing, the economic policies of Kailasa Reserve Bank will be following Vedas and Agamas. For example, a Brahmana Varana person, a Vaidika or a Shivacharya or Bhattacharya or Dikshit, who is practicing Brahmana. Brahmana by the lifestyle, not just by birth, by lifestyle, Varana. Brahmana by Varana. Those Brahmins, all the Sandhya Vandana they do, all the Shiva Puja they do, all the temple worship they do, Pararta Puja or Atmartha Puja or the all the other anushtanas they do, they get punya, which is cosmic currency, with which they can go to Swargaloka, Vaikuntha, Kailasa, Tapoloka and live. They also get country currency, like Swarna Mudra, Purkasu, Kailashian dollar, to run their day-to-day life. So, Kailasa is going to follow the same economic principles. A practicing Varna Brahmanas can encash their lifestyle, spiritual, religious practices and teaching. Not only they get punya, cosmic currency, they get country currency also. And one more thing, they don't need to give their cosmic currency to receive country currency. No, they get both. Cosmic currency they can enjoy by going to Devaloka or Swargaloka or Vaikuntha or Kailasa, wherever they want. Country currency they can withdraw, they can receive from Kailasa. Kailasa government, Reserve Bank of Kailasa, to run their day-to-day life. It will be in various levels, in the form of grains, precious gems, precious metal. That precious metal is the kasus. And the Kailasa, all the Kailasa currency will be gold, as I said. Because the Vedas give gold not just a status of precious, status of sacred. Paramashiva himself is worshipped as Hiranyarupaya, Hiranyavaranam. Mahalakshmi is called as Hiranyavaranam. And Paramashiva is called as Hiranyarupaya. So, Swarna is given status of sacred in Hindu tradition. So, all coins will be, currencies will be in Swarna. Hinduism also declares many other things as dana, wealth. All those will get a legitimate status of wealth. Grain, I'll read out, and the day of release, I'll give all the details.